now until winter gets here, we're gonna have to sluice every day. If we ought to reach our 5,000 ounce goal, because otherwise it isn't gonna happen.
Over halfway through the season, King of the Klondike Tony Beets has just over 2,000 ounces of gold.
5,000 ounces on Paradise Hill is quite a bit of gold. I mean, it's quite simple. More dirt, more sluicing, more gold.
Last week, he mined 472 ounces, his biggest haul this season. Now the pressure is on to keep that level of gold production up.
So right now, we're running 24 hours a day.
Tony is already mining two of the deepest cuts he's ever opened. And to bring in even more gold, he's farmed out land to new tenants.
We leased out some ground to the Winchester boys. They're doing the hunker cut. They have a 200 ounce goal, pick up some royalties from there, so that'll be pretty nice. I haven't seen them for a while. Hopefully they're sluicing away. The more sluicing they do, the more money we make.
The Winchester crew are mining the hunker cut with a skeleton crew of three.
For a small group, I think we're holding our own. I think generally we've been working pretty well together.
Construction worker and mine boss Jason Fraser is hoping to strike it rich.
Well, this is our first season in Dawson, and we're going to strive to do the best we can.
Alongside retired business owner John Van Tyle.
Gold, it's a dream. I take the risk. I go all in.
And ex-logger Butch Bouchard.
Yeah, I quit my job. I had a good living. Normally, when I'm logging, I do good money. But I'm here on the cursed cut.
The Cursed Cut's reputation is legendary after a series of mining failures.
What just happened?
No, they just exploded.
The ground has been untouched since the Beets family left it last season. Until now.
They call it the Cursed Cut. I don't believe in curses.
Sand.
What's going on?
We're packing, John. So we pulled those mats and...
How many yards is this?
400 is about tops.
400 and we get up like this.
Sand.
Black sand is packing these in like cement.
The problem with moving material faster is that it's harder to catch gold. See, there's gold here down low in the box.
Every 400 yards of pay run through the Winchester plant leaves the riffles clogged up with black sand, stopping the gold from settling and allowing it to wash off the end of the sluice box.
It sucks to be having to do cleanups and knocks your production right down at the stage of the game. We should be able to run for a couple of days before we've got to clean these boxes.
Yeah.
Now we're getting, a matter of hours out of them, so it's just a kick in the guts.
We got to figure something out. I think it's enough's enough.
The Winchesters won't make their 200-ounce season target unless wash plant designer John can find a quick fix.
So how's this sluicing going?
The box is sanding up.
Well, it is amazing the amount of black sand in it, yeah.
Holy smoke. And the black sand, the gold climbs on top. We're washing it out the end. We got gold at the end riff. 400-500 yards, and we got to clean up.
Get hydraulic riffles in there. Try that out.
Tony's suggestion is to replace the expanded metal riffles that keep getting blocked up with black sand with hydraulic riffles. These use jets of water to agitate the concentrate, sending the useless black sand out while still allowing the precious gold to settle in the riffles.
Rip the ones out that I have and copy that, that'd be easy.
Yeah.
Get some square tubing.
Yeah.
And then...
Cut them in 3/4-inch strips.
Whatever. There's the day to build them.
Yeah, it won't take long.
That's what you do. You will find one heck of an improvement.
Yeah.
Yep.
people that have done it for 30, 40 years give you advice, you can't say, well, I don't think he knows what he's talking about. But we're taking it and running with it.
Following Tony's design, John uses 3/4-inch tubing and steel plates to weld a hydraulic riffle frame together.
Good. Awesome, they look good, eh? They fit great.
Yeah.
Give it some water. See what the water does. I think we'll throw some dirt in it and see what happens.
Yeah. We're gonna get at it. We're gonna start running some material through and we'll go from there. 2 hours from now, we'll know if they work or they don't.
The Winchester crew run 100 yards of pay to see if Tony's idea has saved their season.
I'll set the feeder down if you wanna get the plant.
Okay. Looks like they're working.
They're working real well.
They're working real well. Nice riffle action here. No gold on top.
Gold will be at the bottom. And gives us more runtime. More runtime is more gold.
Mm-hmm.
I like it. Perfect. Good job, John. Bless you. Water back up and wash some more dirt.
Tony's fix has worked.
With these hydraulic riffles, we'll be able to run 1,200 yards instead of 300 to 400. And that means less downtime for cleanup, more gold at the end, and that'll be the best thing for us.
I come here, you guys are sitting down.
Again.
Tony and Minnie visit the hunker cut to check the Winchester crew's gold return.
How the hell are you guys gonna make me any money at all? Huh? How's the riffles working out for you guys?
They worked very well.
Yeah? You got on a bit longer, though?
Yeah, a little. About every 800 to 1,000 yards, we have to do a cleanup.
Well, there's nothing wrong with that.
There's nothing wrong with that, no.
No.
Yeah, since we got the rock truck from you guys, makes life easier.
That's good, though.
That's good.
Yep.
Makes his mood better.
Always in a good mood.
Okay, well, that's good.
The Winchester crew's last gold weigh delivered only 6 ounces of gold.
Butch, you want to do it, Butch?
Hey, man, pour her in there.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 33, 37, and 41.20.
Sweet.
That's not bad.
So that's good.
That's pretty good, guys.
Pretty good.
It's a fifth of their season goal, worth $70,000.
It's that, you know, the 200-ounce gold is still way out there.
Well, yeah.
We'll get it. We're working toward it.
I think you guys are doing okay.
A win-win for everybody. As long as I get a little bit more than you, then everything is good. I'm happy for you guys. Perfect.
Awesome. Well, thanks for all your help, eh?
Well, I mean, don't worry. Bill is in the mail.